The Society for Industrial Archeology Conference in Seattle in June 2011 will include a trip via vintage transit buses to an opening night reception at the Northwest Railway Museum in the town of Snoqualmie. Along the way, we'll travel on Interstate 90 through the Mount Baker Tunnel and across Lake Washington on what's left of the original 1940 Lacey V. Murrow floating bridge. Other than the raised portions at each end, most of the bridge's original floating concrete pontoons sank while undergoing renovation in 1990. The buses will continue east through a lidded section across the northern tip of Mercer Island, over a waterway called the East Channel, and through the communities of Factoria and Eastgate in the city of Bellevue. The terrain begins to change here, with Cougar Mountain to the right, site of many abandoned coal mines, the southern end of Lake Sammamish to the left, and the Cascades beginning to loom in the distance. Next comes the city of Issaquah, where the highway begins a steep climb into the mountains. The route we'll follow on Interstate 90 roughly corresponds to the path of old U.S. Highway 10, which crossed Snoqualmie Pass for much of the 20th century. Snoqualmie Pass was also the route of the Milwaukee Road Electrified Railway from the teens to the 1970s. In earlier times, Native Americans crossed the pass on foot for hunting and trade. When we exit Interstate 90, we'll take a two-lane highway through the old mill town of Preston. The Preston Mill is gone, but many of the mill workers' compact and tidy homes remain. Then it's north to Fall City, a small town along the banks of the Snoqualmie River, just downstream from Snoqualmie Falls. We cross the river at Fall City and turn right, heading up a steep and winding road that goes past Salish Lodge and Snoqualmie Falls. The falls are, unfortunately, not visible from the highway. Then it's just a short drive to downtown Snoqualmie and the home of the Northwest Railway Museum at the historic Snoqualmie Depot.